Welcome, guys, to Sheer Madness. I'm so nervous. Ooh. Tucker, Virginia. Most awesome race ever. I mean, at least at the hottest track ever. 3 hours of racing around Virginia International Raceway. In the Grand West Course configuration, which is like 1,000 corners. 3 hours, as mentioned, three classes, the Radical SR8, then the Ford GT GT2, and the Roof C-Spec, which I'm in. I'm starting from P14.
Catch the 44 car.
Something wrong with the gridding, I think.
Catch the 25 car, catch the 26.
Not sure.
Car.
Somebody missing, I think.
Car. Catch the 96 car.
Anyway,
catch the
3
car. Catch the
yeah,
boat.
Long race. This will be crazy.
Car. Catch the 23 car.
And especially the middle section is so narrow. Okay. Understand a word. So narrow that multi-class racing will be absolutely crazy. But I'm really looking forward to it. So it's gonna be awesome. I hope I don't crash. That's the main thing. I don't even know how many pit stops I didn't do any sort of race strategy, just put as much fuel in the tank as I could. I think this will be enough for 24 laps, so more than an hour, but I'm not sure. Yeah, this lap, this track is immense. I mean, it's so great. We're still on the normal section, the normal layout. Here, coming up to the S's, which are almost flat out in this car. Maybe the alien drivers can take it flat out, I'm not sure. But it's a lot of fun. I can't even imagine how that must feel in real life, going through there. And we're coming up to legendary Oak Tree Bend, which is just behind my rearview mirror. There it is. Famous Oak Tree. As far as I know, it doesn't exist in real life anymore, unfortunately. Then the long back street.
Catch the 34 car.
Hey, you can see the pace car already. It's already in the infield section. Yeah, the field in this race is incredible. So the competition is so good. I think it might be even better than in the Neo series. I'm not sure, but yeah, a couple of seconds off the pace of the leading guys. There are 20 roofs in their series. There should be 20 at least. And yeah, as you can see, I'm starting from 13th. Although I'm not sure. Maybe there's somebody missing because I should be in 14th actually. Doesn't matter. Okay, can't understand a word. Judging by the warm-up times, the guys ahead of me are probably quicker than me. We're still in the infield check section, by the way. I didn't continue my tour through the lap. I'm sorry, guys. Okay, we're quite far back. Andre, guy ahead of me, must have sort of fallen asleep a little bit. Start sort of happened. That's all I can say. Careful. Okay. Very civilized. Everybody's super careful at the moment. Except the guy behind me. Maybe. This is where we leave the main track. Ahead of me is either slow or he knows something about the tires that I don't know. So we're picking up the pace now. Too wide. Definitely early on the throttle than I am. In this final corner. Already somebody in the pits. I think Jonathan is a Ford GT driver. Didn't see the color code. Focusing on the car ahead and not on the track, it's not good. At least there's a bit of a gap behind me. Short race for Jonathan. I wondered. A much more direct approach to that corner. Better. My goal is a top 10 finish. If I can reach that, I'm really happy. Thank you. What am I doing? Unfortunately, I can't shake the guy behind me. Me and that gearbox. Coming closer again. Careful with your tires. That's the problem with this car. As you start losing weight at the front, because that's where the tank is, it starts to understeer. I guess my setup is a bit too conservative. Brake bias one click to the rear. Track. Mm-hmm. Secondly, it's pretty warm weather and it's unrealistic weather. The track is pretty hot. That's also something this car does not like at all. Well, actually, it's realistic weather plus I don't know how many degrees, because I don't think. It's, I don't know, 27 or 29 degrees Celsius in Virginia in December. Closer and closer. Turn in. I can hear a reticle already. Straight. Probably taking too much curbs here. It's so narrow. This time I'll be a bit more careful regarding drinking. If you have seen, if you've watched my video of the Targa Long Pond 120 race, which was a 2-hour race, same organizer, which has nothing to do with the problem I just will be talking about, namely. About 1 hour or so, or even less, I think, 40 minutes. My bladder said, hey Martin, are you sure about this race? I'd like you to go somewhere. Something along those lines. Oh damn. He's close now. Speaking of drinking. Luckily, the radical field isn't that big. Oh, come on. I blame that on my windshield. seconds away. Top speed is pretty close between the three classes. That's a problem on the straights. Stupid. It's not worth it. Yeah. Take the chance if you see it. We lost a lot of time there, but at least I gained my got my position back. Main problem, of course, was that I missed my braking point into turn one. Okay, guys ahead will also lose time, probably. It was already my pedal cam. Still only half an hour of pedal cam footage possible. Really bad here. Seems to be stuck behind Gresham. Okay. Just gonna go for it. No, he's not.
Clear on the left.
actually would have preferred if he went for it the previous corner. I don't think I lost too much time. Can see that the radical, you probably won't be able to see that in the rear mirror, but the radical is only just able to pass the roof on the straight. It's even worse with the Fords. Door to open there. Wasn't meant as an invitation. Too hot. Close enough. And next radical in 3 seconds. I hate this section here. I can't lift. Should be okay. Must be better on the brakes. Tires are just dropped off. I hope this... Was he next to me? No, I don't think so. I really don't hope so. Say anything. Really hope he wasn't next to me. Very late in the fight. What am I doing? You see? You should be okay on the brakes. Whoa, whoa, whoa. Go through. I want you to go through. Please. And not lose it, actually. Whew. A lot of time. The last lap. I really didn't see what happened to Gresham. Oh well. Forget about it now. Can't change it anyway. Oh, there he is. Still 7 seconds behind me. Okay, he's still running. Good. Tires already feel a bit problematic and I think I'm only halfway through the stint. It's one of the areas where I still have to learn a lot. I mean, making setups anyway, but making a setup that is actually preserves the tires. Guy must have crashed. He's still behind me, or again behind me. I love it. Clear. That's the guy, actually. He's in the same lap. Don't do anything silly. Don't do anything. Really? That is silly. That is really silly. Oh boy. Should have known. You just don't go there side by side. You don't. Probably he didn't plan to, but once you show your nose on the inside, I have to expect you to dive to the inside, and then I have to make room. And there is just no room there. And both of us will lose a lot of time. That's the main thing. Black flag for Lucas. Don't even know if he's in our class. Safe track entry. Okay. Guys in the pits, very early. It's either a crash or one of them is Jonathan Patel. Okay, he's in my class. Either a crash or they are doing the odd stint at the beginning, a short one. Is a risky strategy. Third possibility would be that he was stuck behind the car. No, it doesn't. Doesn't work. That could work. Of course it could. Too hot. Six seconds to Dean, eight to Andre, 13 seconds to Manuel. Everything is possible still. It's a long, very long race. I don't think I'll be able to beat one of those guys by speed, by pace, but maybe accidents, whatever. Further backwards, rearwards. case you're wondering why I'm running. It's very awkward. Livery. There's actually a paint scheme motto in this race. Yeah, running classic liveries. I sort of thought about making my own or adapting the Slipstream Racing one, but I couldn't come up with anything really good. So I found this one here on Trading Paints. I like it. And it's certainly a classic. Too late. See, I'm definitely becoming slower over the course of a fuel run. Although the car is getting lighter. A, the tires are degrading, and B, as I mentioned, the handling just changes to the worse. The other guys seem to be better. Adjusting to that, or adjusting their setups to that, or both. Another guy in the pits, very early again, and that is one of the really quick guys. Oh, and he's directly behind me. Great. He's probably also thinking, great. I will not fight him. And he's got the two leading Fords behind him. I was slower than he anticipated. Nice. I guess I wasn't to be now. Driving corner entry, and then I have to slow down to get the nose in again. That's what's slowing me down. Top speed is really good. Maybe he has some damage.
left side. Clear on the left. Car on your left. Clear.
That was a bit scary. I'll admit it. The reason why I knew that the Porsche that just passed me, Renz, why I knew he's probably a lot quicker than me, was A, because I knew he was qualified a lot higher than I did, and B, he's driving for Coanda Simsport. This is that crazy team with all the plus 7,000 I-rating guys. Ford that got the black flag, he's in the same lap like me, and I passed Andre, he's in the pits. I don't know what everybody's doing regarding pit stops. Either all the guys are crashing without me noticing, or a different strategy. I looked into the rear view mirror and didn't even notice I was going sideways. I'm so lucky. Should let this guy pass. So was he, by the way. He's probably scared now. So much for the car starts to understeer. I mentioned I hate this section. Egil is in the pits. All those guys really did the math and maths, and I will lose again at the end because I have to do a short splash. How you do it, as mentioned so often. You really can see how the quick guys are quick through traffic, and it's no drama, it's all good. He's just not quick out of the corners onto the streets. What should I do? And go. Great.
Not clear on the left.
Those are super close. Yeah, great. Yeah, anyway, Eagle was not in my race. It was Jörn, another Coranda Sim Sport driver. Thank you. least Gresham even lost more time than I did. He's driving for Super Sport Racing, I think. They are also in the new Endurance Series, only they couldn't make the first race. So for Kota, next weekend, it should be a competition, actually. Okay, fuel... 3 laps, nope, not gonna make that. That's close, okay, 2 laps.
Thanks, Vic.
And most importantly, windshield wipe thing clear. Said my goal was top 10, but which I am right now, but only because a couple of guys have pitted, actually. He just wanted to have an ideal position for this straight, but look, I wasn't sure if he would make the move there. These two guys are fighting each other. I guess that was a bit of netcode too.
I'm gonna pit.
Blinked immediately after that incident. Okay, Jasper's 4 seconds behind. Probably should communicate. 2 hours remaining. Numbers. Still far enough away. Good. Hits like we did last time. Have something to drink. Just brake bias. New pit guy, by the way. All 3D and fancy stuff. Behind me, forward, 2 Fords going through. Okay, we have sort of clear space. Is that Bush ahead of me? Is that Radical behind? Oh. Unfortunately, only Fords, it seems. I can see again. Ah, the car drives just so much better.
Thank you, mate. You turned into me, dude. Don't thank me, thank yourself.
Car handles so much different. That's the key to being quick in this car. Understanding how that works and why it is, and how to build the setup around this. And I've lost 2 to 3 seconds to Gresham in that pit stop. Thing is, I passed Andy. Andy's still behind me. Andy Goodison, and yeah, that means I'm really ahead of him in the race. Yeah, I have to go over the curbs there. Seems to be the line. Oh boy. You don't go into the grass there. You do that once and then you maybe get back to the racetrack. Maybe. That was an off track, really. Pointless, really. He's too far away. the question. If I maybe I would have lost less time had I let him pass before the S's. I'm not sure about that though. Maybe top 10 finish. Still realistic. By the way, this section here, to continue my tour of the track, I nearly run off, is built after famous corkscrew in Laguna Seca, only sort of mirrored. Passed another guy, not sure. Yeah, Dean. It's really different to run a race like this without any teammates. Regaining me, it's not good. Really bad. Losing time and destroying tires. So there's three guys not very far behind me. So one spin and I lose three positions. Oh boy. There's Jonathan Boutel. A lap down, actually. Interesting. Pitting again. Okay, I guess his car is trash. Eagles again in the pits. Okay. In case you don't know, Eagle is one of the two guys that make Neo, the organizers of the Neo Endurance Series. Probably butchering his first name, I'm sorry. But I don't think Egil is correct either, so... trail braking also doesn't help on the steering, or it helps on the steering, but actually doesn't help the handling of the car. Well, to be correct, it only helps on the steering because for this actually my brake bias, I guess, is actually too far forwards. So I'm a bit on the brakes. I don't know, can't think now. Oh. Oh damn. Yes, it wasn't Dean's car which was damaged, but his steering wheel, his force feedback wheel. That's a shame, it's really very unlucky. At least it seems he didn't take anybody out. What did Gresham do? How is he gaining that quickly? And one Ford, if I'm correct. Yep. Oh. Much less traffic than I expected to be. It's either because many people have crashed, which I don't think so actually. He's going for a dive bomb. And then go. Please. That cost us both a lot of time. I mean a lot. Yeah, I think he's one of the slower guys in the class. Maybe it's pretty new. But that gave Gresham another second. Gear. was I? Yeah, either many people crashed, or it's just because this track is so long. I think around 48 cars, maybe less, not sure. Strike leader. Say most people are really patient. Need some time on him again, that's good. It was close to the grass. Right at that moment I hit the brakes, or at least I touched them. Scary. Maybe I'll make two parts of this. Probably. Okay, even if P9 gets taken from me by Gresham, 11th place is 20 seconds spare. So my goal, a top 10 finish, is realistic right now. Thank you. rear. A lap roof. I know this guy is a Club DH driver, and if you look at his paint job, it's pretty clear where he's coming from. Make it easy for me, that's for sure. Oh, that one radical driver got a black flag. That one I was talking about earlier was in the same lap and made that move into the S's. Yeah, that has allowed Gresham to close in again. But he has to get by Dominic too, so... And he, don't get me wrong, he didn't do anything nasty or so. He could have made it easier for both of us. That's what I wanted to say. Oh boy. I'm not lucky. Gresham will pass him here. Pretty sure. Yep, he did.